In this video, we're going to look at simple linear regression model in Excel using the calculation method. Here we have the data of weekly family expenditure and weekly family income for 10 households. The first step is to identify which of the variables is the dependent and which is the independent variable. So here, the weekly family expenditure depends on the weekly family income. So, weekly family income is the X variable or the independent variable, and weekly family expenditure is the dependent variable or Y variable. Now let's take a look at the question given. The table gives data on weekly family consumption expenditure and weekly family income. Estimate the consumption function of the family, which is the regression equation. Estimate the variance and the standard error. Test the significance of parameters at 5% level of significance. Find R square. Write the economic interpretation of the estimated results. Now we're going to do that in Excel using the calculation method step by step. Now we're going to take a look at the estimation of the coefficients beta naught and beta 1. Which we'll use to frame the regression equation, which is y cap is equal to beta naught cap plus beta 1 cap x. So let's see how we can do that. The first step is to find xy. We can calculate by this formula equal to, click on the x variable into, click on the y variable, press enter and drag it. And then we're going to calculate x square. So we can do that by this formula equal to, click on the x variable, multiplied by, click on the x variable again, press enter and drag the values. We can do the same to calculate the y square variable. So we can do that by this formula equal to, click on y, into, click on y again, press enter and drag the formula. Now that we've calculated xy, x square and y square, we're going to sum up all the values of y, x, xy, x square and y square. We can do that by a simple formula equal to sum, open bracket, select all the y values and close the bracket. Now we can just drag the formula to calculate the sum of the other variables. So now to estimate beta 1, the formula is n into sigma xy minus sigma x into sigma y divided by n into sigma x square minus sigma x the whole square. And to calculate beta naught, we use the formula y bar minus beta 1 cap x bar, where y bar is the average of y that is calculated by summing up the y values and dividing by n. Similarly, x bar is the mean of x, which is calculated by summing up the x values and dividing by n. So to calculate beta 1 cap and beta naught cap, we need n, y bar and x bar. Since the number of households is 10, n is 10. To calculate y bar, we use the formula sigma y by n. So sigma y is 1110, as we calculated earlier, divided by n, which is 10. Press enter. This will give the y bar value. Similarly, for x bar, we calculate by using this formula equal to sigma x divided by n. Press enter. Now that we have the n, y bar and x bar values, we can calculate beta 1 cap and beta naught cap. So to calculate beta 1 cap, we're going to use this formula equal to open bracket, insert another open bracket. Pay attention to the number of brackets that you insert because the calculation could be wrong if you miss out a bracket. Click n into, click sigma xy close bracket minus open bracket sigma x into sigma y. Close bracket, add another close bracket, divided by open bracket, click on n into sigma x square, close bracket minus open bracket again, sigma x into sigma x, close bracket, press enter. So this will give us beta 1 cap value of 0.51. Now let's calculate the beta naught value. We can use this formula equal to y bar minus open bracket, click on beta 1 cap into click on x bar, close bracket and press enter. This will give the beta naught cap value of 24.45. Now we have estimated the regression coefficients beta naught and beta 1. Now we can formulate the regression equation. The regression equation is of the format y cap is equal to beta naught plus beta 1 cap x. We have estimated beta naught to be 24.45 and beta 1 cap to be 0.51. So our estimated regression equation is y cap is equal to 24.45 plus 0.51x. We'll be looking at how to interpret this regression equation at the end of the video. For the next step, we're going to calculate the variance and standard error of the coefficients. Now we have calculated sigma x, sigma y, sigma x square, sigma y square, sigma xy, n, y bar, x bar, beta 1 cap and beta naught cap. So to calculate the variance of beta naught and beta 1, we're going to use this formula. Variance of beta 1 cap is equal to sigma square u divided by sigma xi square. And to calculate the variance of beta naught, we use this formula, sigma square u sigma xi square divided by n sigma xi square. Note that on the numerator we have the capital X and on the denominator we have the small letter x. So make sure you are able to differentiate between the capital X and the small x. Sigma square u can be calculated by the formula sigma ei square by n minus 2, where sigma ei square is equal to sigma yi square minus beta 1 cap square sigma xi square. Sigma yi square is equal to sigma capital yi square minus sigma y the whole square divided by n. Similarly, sigma xi square is equal to sigma capital xi square minus sigma x the whole square by n. Now, we're going to need these variables in order to calculate the variance and standard error of beta 1 cap and beta naught cap. So these variables are sigma x square, sigma y square, sigma e square and sigma square u. So let's calculate sigma x square first. We can use this formula equal to sigma capital xi square minus, insert two open brackets here, click on sigma x into, click on sigma x again, close bracket, divided by n which is 10, close bracket and press enter. So the sigma x square is 33,000. Similarly, we can calculate sigma y square by this formula equal to, click on sigma y square minus open bracket twice, click on sigma y into sigma y again, close bracket, divided by n, close bracket and press enter. This gives the sigma y square value of 8890. Now we can calculate sigma e square by using this formula equal to sigma yi square minus open bracket again, beta 1 cap into, click on beta 1 cap again, close bracket, into sigma xi square, close bracket, and press enter. This will give the sigma ei square value of 337.27. Now we can calculate sigma u square. This is equal to sigma ei square divided by open bracket n minus 2, close bracket, and press enter. This will give us the sigma square u value of 42.16. Now we can calculate the variance of beta 1 cap, which is equal to sigma square u divided by sigma xi square. This gives the value of 0.00128. For variance of beta naught cap, we can use the formula equal to sigma square u into sigma xi square, note that this is the capital X, divided by open bracket n into sigma xi square, this is the small xi square, close bracket, and press enter. This will give us the variance of beta naught. Now to calculate the standard error, we need to take square root of the variance. So the standard error of beta 1 cap is equal to sqrt, open bracket, click on the variance beta 1 cap, close bracket, and press enter. Similarly, for standard error of beta naught cap, we can use the formula equal to sqrt, open bracket, click on variance of beta naught cap, close bracket, and press enter. Now we have calculated the variance and standard errors for our coefficients beta naught cap and beta 1 cap. Next, we're going to test the hypothesis of the coefficients. Before we start with calculating the t statistics, we need to look at the null hypothesis and the alternate hypothesis. We test the null hypothesis that beta 1 is equal to 0, which means that the coefficient is statistically insignificant. If we reject this null hypothesis, we can say that beta 1 is not equal to 0, which means that beta 1 is statistically significant. So first of all, we're going to calculate the t-stat of beta 1. t-stat of beta 1 is equal to beta 1 cap divided by the standard error of beta 1 cap. We have already calculated the n, standard error of beta 1 cap, standard error of beta naught cap, beta 1 cap and beta naught cap earlier. Now we're going to calculate the t-stat of beta 1. We can use this formula equal to click on beta 1 cap divided by click on the standard error of beta 1 cap. This will give us the t-statistics value of beta 1. We also need to calculate the critical t-value, which is t0.025. To do that, we need the degrees of freedom, df. Df can be calculated by the formula n minus k, where n is the number of households or the samples and k is the number of coefficients we have, which is 2. So to calculate df, we just need to minus 10, which is our n value, by 2, which is our k value. This gives us a degree of freedom 8. Now, we need to look at the t table to find out the value of t0.025. t0.025 is over here and the degree of freedom 8 is over here. For degrees of freedom 8, t0.025 is 2.306. So t0.025 is 2.306. Now, we need to compare t0.025 with the t-stat of beta 1 that we calculated. Here, the t stat of beta 1 is greater than t 0.025. So we reject the null hypothesis that beta 1 is equal to 0. So this means that beta 1 is statistically significant. Similarly, to test the hypothesis of beta naught, we first calculate the t-stat of beta naught by using this formula equal to click on beta naught divided by the standard error of beta naught. Press enter. This will give us the t-stat value of beta naught. We already calculated t 0.025, which is 2.306. Like beta 1, t stat of beta naught is also greater than t 0.025. So we reject the null hypothesis that beta naught is equal to 0, and we conclude that beta naught is statistically significant. Now we're going to calculate the R square. R square is the goodness of fit of the regression model. To calculate the R-square, there are two formulas. One is R-square is equal to beta 1 cap the whole square into sigma xi square divided by sigma yi square. Note that both the letters x and y are small. Or we can use the formula R-square is equal to 1 minus sigma ei square by sigma yi square. We have already calculated n, beta 1 cap, sigma x square, sigma y square and sigma ei square. Now let's apply them in the formula. So we put equal to open bracket again, beta 1 cap into beta 1 cap multiplied by sigma x square, close bracket, divided by sigma yi square, close bracket and press enter. So this will give us 0.96206. We can also use this formula equal to 1 minus open bracket sigma ei square divided by sigma yi square, close bracket and click enter. As you can see, both the formulae give the same result. With this R square, we can say that 96.2% of the variations in y are explained by x. Finally, let's look at the interpretation of the results. So far, we have calculated the regression coefficients and framed the regression equation. We have calculated the variance and the standard errors for beta 1 cap and beta naught cap. And we have also calculated the R square. Now let's interpret these results. First of all, let's look at the variables, weekly family consumption and weekly family income. In economics, it is known that the consumption expenditure of a family generally depends on the level of income of the family. The estimated consumption equation shows that the autonomous consumption is ₹24.47. That is, if the income is zero, the average level of consumption expenditure of the family is ₹24.47. Please note that if in the data that you're using, the value of the independent variable x cannot be zero, then it is redundant to use the intercept, that is the beta 1 value. The coefficient of the x variable, that is beta 1, is equal to 0.51, measures the slope of the consumption expenditure line. It indicates that if income increases by ₹100, the estimated increase in average consumption expenditure is ₹51. The marginal propensity to consume is less than 1 here. The value of R square 0.96 indicates that about 96% of the variation in the consumption expenditure is explained by income. Finally, we can say that the estimated coefficients of beta 1 cap and beta naught cap are statistically significant at 5% level of significance by the hypothesis testing that we did. This is how we can calculate and interpret the results of a simple linear regression model with one dependent and one independent variable.